It may look like something out of a science fiction movie, but technology like this could be key to recovering the underwater wreckage of missing Malaysian Flight 370.
Technology is giving a man the feeling that he's sitting there and he's doing this with his own arms.
It's called an ROV, or remotely operated vehicle.
But that, you know, when you say 11 times...
Paul Colley is the chief operating officer at Total Marine Technology, a Malaysian company based in Australia. They build and operate ROVs for the oil and gas industry.
Actually, how you would grab it and recover it is really going to be a decision you're going to make on the day. We have something like an IKEA drawer that sits underneath the ROV that you can push that drawer out, put objects in, and suck it back into the ROV.
Each of these joints represents a joint on the arm, and every move I make, it mimics. This looks like it would be easy, but it's not. And what happens when things go wrong?
Generally, they go badly wrong. So you don't know exactly what you're going to get every time you put the ROV in the water.
And a lot can go wrong when you have 5 tons of metal and electronics tethered to an umbilical cord thousands of meters beneath the ocean surface. Paul says each year 5% of the world's ROV fleet goes missing.
If water gets in to somewhere where it shouldn't do, then what it's going to do is probably damage the electronics.
Further complicating the picture, any silt on the ocean floor. If disturbed,
it's like driving in fog.
Total Marine Technologies ROVs can operate in water 3.5 kilometers deep, about a kilometer short of the depth believed to be MH370's final resting place. They have not been asked to help in the search.
Our, owner is very interested in how we can adapt the technology to get down to that depth. You know, engineering is at its best when it's serving humanity.
And helping to solve one of the greatest mysteries in aviation history. ERIN-MCLAUGHLIN, CNN, Perth, Australia.